Hey guys, welcome back. So for today's video, I'm doing another collaboration, and this time it's with Blacksummer Colouring, Hit Art, and Illustration with Eveii. We decided to send art supplies to each other, sort of like a secret Santa, but not so secret because we knew who was sending what, we just didn't know what they were sending. And I sent supplies over to Eveii, and Eveii to Claire, Claire to Christina, and Christina to me. I hope I'm saying names right, but anyway. I had no idea what Christina was going to send to me, and I was just really excited to see what it was when it came. I think mine actually arrived first, I don't remember, but yeah, we did time in who got to who first, but yeah, that was just a little bit of fun. And she sent me this lovely Christmas card that had the theme in, and she wanted me to do a picture that was titled Mermaid of the Frozen Lake and incorporate jellyfish. And I loved drawing jellyfish and she knew that, so that's why she put it in there. But anyway, the first supply that I opened was a pack of pipettes, which I've not used since I was at school, so I was quite looking forward to seeing what else was in there so I could use those. The next thing was a pack of Staedtler metallic markers in gold and silver, and I've never used these pens, so I was excited to see how they would work, because I don't really use metallic markers anyway. I have some of the metallic paint markers, but I don't like them very much, so I don't really use them. The next thing was a 6-well paint palette, and I wanted to save the biggest one till last, because it was the biggest and heavy, and in fact this must be the main one, and it was. So I was really excited to open this one, and it turned out to be absolutely amazing, because it was the Windsor and Newton drawing inks, and I wanted this set of drawing inks for a very long time now. It's been on my wish list for a long time, and yeah, I just never got around to getting it. But just to go over what everything was again, it's the Windsor & Newton drawing inks, some pipettes, the metallic markers, and a paint palette. Now, when I was sketching, I was really inspired as soon as I saw the theme, and I just drew loads of mermaids in my little Ryman sketchbook, just A6 one, just to get a little thumbnail down, because I didn't really know exactly what I wanted to do at first. And I ended up going with the one that you can see now. It's like a very flexible mermaid, well not very, but sort of bent a bit more, because I wanted to do a different pose than I normally would, and so I wanted this one because it would quite like kind of flow with the idea, because I wanted it to be underwater. But when I was transferring it and redrawing it bigger, it didn't quite have the same bend in the spine that I wanted, but I'm happy with how it turned out anyway. I do need to practice more elaborate poses like that. Here you can just see I'm just testing out all the supplies, so I just tested the gold and silver pens and all the little inks, and the bottles are so cute, I love the little square bottles that they've got, but yeah. And then I transferred my sketch over to my new watercolour paper, which is the De La Rowney A3 300g hot press smooth paper, which is a bit different. I don't normally use smooth paper, I use textured. And the inks didn't really like it much, but it still worked, it just took a little bit more work. But I'm not used to using inks either, so it was a bit more difficult anyway, because I don't normally use them. But anyway, my idea for the piece was to do this bendy mermaid sitting on top of a lion's mane jellyfish, because those things get huge, and I love the colours, sort of reaching up to a hole in the ice, and then I did like crystals in the bottom, just to give it more of a frozen feel under the water. And I started off by covering the mermaid and the top part of the jellyfish with my Windsor & Newton masking fluid, and then I went in with the black ink and ultramarine to get the base down for the lighting and the shadows. So I wanted the edges to be quite dark to show the light coming down from above and sort of illuminating the mermaid and the jellyfish. And then after that I got the purple, which is actually kind of more pinky, and the yellow, which wasn't as bright yellow as I was hoping, but it still worked, and painted the first part to the jellyfish. Now I found when I was doing this, the best way I found to paint with inks was just doing loads of layers, which is what I normally do with markers, so that didn't really bother me too much, but it was a lot of waiting for it to dry, and this piece took me about 3 days to do, mainly because on a couple of the days I had a bit of a break, because I just wasn't motivated at all to do any art, even though I really wanted to get this one finished. I just couldn't bring myself to do anything, so I just organised calendars and stuff like that, but boring stuff. I did ask Christina if I could use my own art supplies along with the one she sent me just to help bring the piece together, because there was nothing I could use for a skin tone, and well, I could have used like the blues and done a bluish tone, but I thought it might be a bit too blue then, so I used my acrylic inks because I wanted to try and stay with just using inks for the most of the picture. And I used my acrylic skin tone ink and my new teal one. And I used a bit of my new pearlescent black one in the background just to give it a bit of a shine, but it doesn't really show up very well, so it was kind of pointless. And I tried to use the ultramarine that was in the set from Hushina to do the shadows on her skin, because I wanted her to stand out from the background, but not too much, because then she wouldn't blend in like and be underwater. And when I was painting it, oh yes, I actually used my brown acrylic ink as well, or sepia paint, because the brown in the set from Hushina wasn't as dark as I wanted for the hair. So a lot of the time when I was doing this, I was painting it in one colour ink and then redoing it because I didn't like it. And it was a lot of decision making and changing my thought process constantly throughout it. Like here you can see I painted the tail green originally with the inks for Hushina, and then I didn't like how that looked with the rest of it. At the time, I kind of do now seeing it on screen, but I do prefer the teal tail that I did instead. So I mixed my teal, because that is still quite greenish, with the blue from the set that I was given, and a bit of my white, which I need a new one of those because it's not very good at all really. But yeah, it's a bit chalky, and it is really old though, so I'm not surprised it doesn't work very well. But anyway, when I was doing it, I was actually originally going to do red hair again, which it's another aerial mermaid, yay, like all my others tend to do. And I was trying to avoid that, which is why I went for the dark brown hair, because I didn't want it to be another aerial. I like the teal tail, but that just seems to be the generic thing I go for, is teal tail, red hair, and it's aerial. That's it. But no. So I needed to have a break from that, and I wanted to get a different colour in the end of the tail, like to give it a bit of a pop against the blue background. And I wanted to tie in the colours from the jellyfish to the mermaid, so I actually did a bit of the purple in the base of the tail going into the teal from the rest of the tail. But I know one thing, painting jellyfish in inks is not easy for me. It took quite a while to get it how I liked it, and using a mixture of my pencil crayons in the end, my white gel pen and my white ink, just to get that translucent and the transparent look in a jellyfish. The colours are really nice and vibrant, which is great if you do vibrant colours, but trying to get them to go pastel-y and see-through, I did struggle a little bit. I like how it came out, but it took a lot of work. But yeah, the purple ink was, I have to say, I think that was one of my favourite inks, because the colour on it was just so bright, and it was easy to blend with other colours, but I don't know, I like the colour. I'm not really a fan of purple or pink normally, but that one worked really well. Now I'm doing the crystals in the bottom, and I wanted to try and make sure I got the lights, like the colour coming from the jellyfish, just so it would tie in, because obviously if there is a light source shining down on like frozen crystals, then if there is any colours around it, I'd pick up and it'd be in the reflection. So I was using my Prismacolor crayons to try and get that across. It did lose some of the footage sadly, but you saw some of it, so it's okay. But then I lined it all with a mixture of my Micron Sakura Micron multi-liner and Pentel brush pen. Just the details on the face were quite small, I just used my 0.1 liner and then swapped over to my brush pen for the rest of it. And I like using the brush pen to get the different line weight, so it just gives it a bit more dimension to the piece. And especially on hair, I think it works really well on hair. But I then outlined it with my white gel pen, just making it stand out a little bit more. And I will admit, I actually forgot that I had to use the gold and silver markers until right at the end, so I used those to add a bit of highlights and shadows. But yeah, anyway, we're at the end of the video now, so I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to go and check out everyone else's, and please like and subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!